Hey buddy, I use and recommend Debian for all my servers. In this video, we will see how to upgrade from Debian 9 Stretch to Debian 10 Buster, which released on September 7th of 2019. It is highly recommended to have a full system backup before attempting to upgrade. Although Debian is very stable and does not break, when a lot of packages get updated, it is always a good idea to have a backup. First, let's open a web browser. As I have a fresh install of Debian Stretch, we will use the Firefox ESR version that comes pre-installed. Now, let's head over to debgen.xyz, where we will get the repositories list for Debian 10 Buster. First thing that we will do here is to select emitter. Though I live in India, I always use United States emitter as they are more faster and reliable. The website hasn't been updated yet to mark Debian Buster as a stable, so we will manually select Debian Buster as our release. Note that selecting a release that is older than you already have will probably break your system, so please make sure of the release you are currently using and the release you want to upgrade to. If you don't know which version of Debian you're using, just wait a few minutes as I will show you at the end of this video. Most of you will have a 64-bit computer, so select AMD 64 as the architecture. If you are using a 32-bit installation of Debian, you can select i386 in the architecture select box. Also, be sure to select the right architecture as installing the wrong one will also cause a lot of problems. Now, clicking on the Make It So button will generate the source list which we can give to apt package manager, which will then download newer packages. Let's copy the generated source list and close Firefox as we no longer need it. The next step would be to open a terminal and log in as the root user. To switch to the root user, tap the command sudo-i and press enter. Enter the password of your user that you are currently logged in and press enter. Once we have switched to the root user, let's take a backup of the existing sources.list file. To do that, run the command cp /etc/apt/sources.list/etc/apt/sources.list/backup. Clearing the existing sources.list is the next thing to do. For that, we will just echo an empty text into the sources.list file. The reason why we don't delete and recreate the file is because sometimes the permissions of this file can be a problem. To install the new sources into the file, let's run nano /etc/apt/sources.list. Which should open the nano text editor. If you are good at Vim and you have Vim or Emacs installed on your system, you can also use those text editors. Once we have a text editor opened for that file, simply paste the sources.list we copied from debgen.xyz. I will simply right-click and select paste. Now, save the file and exit the editor. To do that in nano, press Ctrl-O to save and Ctrl-X to exit out of nano. Now, we can exit out of the root user by simply running exit. As we now have installed the new sources list, we will update the software repository database by running sudo apt update. Now, the process may take longer than usual as the entire database will be updated rather than just updating the changes. We will also get this error saying the subprocess returned an error code, but it is safe to proceed. To start upgrading all the packages, run the command sudo apt upgrade. When asked if to continue or not, simply type Y and press enter to confirm upgrading to Debian 10 Buster. Now, apt package manager will start downloading all the packages for which newer versions are available. Note that this might take some time depending on the number of packages to upgrade. As the time goes, the upgrade becomes more risky with more packages needing to upgrade. I would say if you're upgrading to Debian 10 after January of 2020, it would be better to just do a clean format and freshly install Debian 10. Make sure you don't have a screensaver or have your system go to sleep, as that would interrupt the upgrading process and you will end up with a broken system. As I would not like to waste your time, we will just fast forward until the downloading and installation gets finished. In between the upgrade process, apt might give you a few prompts like this, for which you can continue to read or press Q to continue upgrading to Debian 10 Buster. In this screen, you can simply press Enter to continue, and press Enter once again to not make any changes to the mini SSD PD daemon. Now press Tab to get the focus to the OK text, and then press Enter to continue. When APT Package Manager prompts you asking whether to restart services during the upgrade process, it is recommended to press No, so we will just press Enter. In this screen too, press Tab to focus the OK text, and press Enter to continue. The same should be done for this prompt too. Let's press Enter for this prompt. In this screen, we need to select a drive or partition to reinstall Grub Bootloader. As I only have one drive, which is SDA, I will select it. Note that installing Grub on the drive itself is better than installing it on a wrong partition. To select a drive or partition, press up or down arrow keys to move and spacebar to mark the drive or partition for installation. Once you have selected the drive or partition where Grub will be reinstalled, you again, just like before, press Tab key to focus the OK text and press Enter to continue. So the downloading and installation took around 45 minutes with a 50 megabits per second connection and 2 gigabytes of RAM on a VirtualBox instance. As upgrading all the packages is completed, the next step would be to upgrade the distribution itself, for which we will run the command sudo apt dist-upgrade. Again, press Y and hit Enter to start downloading. The command sudo apt upgrade downloads and installs new packages that aren't the core operating system itself. The command that we now have issued, which is sudo apt dist-upgrade, will download and install the newer core system packages. Again, on the screen, pressing Q will continue the installation. Once the command has finished executing, we have upgraded from Debian 9 Stretch to Debian 10 Buster. The last thing that we have to do now is to reboot the system, for which we will give the command sudo reboot now. Now let's log into our newly upgraded Debian 10 Buster. There we go. We now have successfully upgraded from Debian 9 Stretch to Debian 10 Buster. The exact same method will work for upgrading from Debian Stable Branch to Debian Unstable or testing branches where you will find even newer packages. And also, this is the same method used for upgrading your servers that run Debian. Please check out the article written on my website to know more about upgrading Debian. Finally, to check which version of Debian we are running, let's open a terminal and run the command lsb_release-a. After Arch Linux, Debian is my favorite Linux distribution. If you face any issues while upgrading or have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below and I will try to respond as soon as possible. So, that was it for this video. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos like this. This is Vasant Developer, signing off.